after World War II, a new eugenics was resurrected out of the bones and ashes of the old eugenics. The eugenics movement has been at the forefront to establish a new scientific racism that justifies oppression and exploitation and racism.
Infatti, il razzismo è inseparabile dalle radici della psichiatria.
The entire history of psychiatry, beginning with scientific conclusions that were made in the 1830s, was an effort to prove the intellectual inferiority of African Americans.
Benjamin Rush is the father of modern psychiatry, and he is the one that gave us the term nigritude. He said that all blacks have inherited this disease, and this particular disease, it caused them to be inferior. In addition to that, it was the reason why it was very important that blacks remain segregated and separate from whites so that whites did not inherit this disease.
Sostenendo che la negritudine fosse una forma di lebbra, Rush giustificò la segregazione come una necessità medica. Questo favorì la continuazione della schiavitù.
The fact that you have brutalized a whole group of people had nothing to do with that. It had everything to do with some genetic link and that basically you are just a diseased person, so when a slave master wanted to get rid of a recalcitrant slave, they could just say, oh, well, they're suffering from this disease.
Dreptomania, that is the name of the mental disorder that was contrived by Samuel Cartwright, who said that blacks have a mental disorder if they had a desire to run away from slavery.
Running away became such a common problem that psychiatrists attempted to give that a disease. He says, but that's a cure for that. And the question was, well, what's the cure for that? Frequent whippings. You'd be surprised how that disease clears up when the lash is put in place of their excuses.
Dopo che la schiavitù venne abolita, il razzismo psichiatrico non solo continuò, ma si intensificò. L'American Journal of Psychiatry proclamò ufficialmente che i negri, visto che discendevano da selvaggi e cannibali, erano mal preparati ad una migliore civiltà. Nel frattempo, la pseudoscienza dell'eugenetica intensificava le sue attività razziste.
There is a clear and long and intimate connection between the eugenics movement and the Ku Klux Klan. Harry Lachlan, who was the Carnegie Institution's director of the Eugenics Record Office, had close relationship to the Ku Klux Klan through the publication of a book called White America, which was written by a major Klan leader. So Lachlan wrote a glowing review of the book in the Eugenics News. And at the same time, you have the Ku Klux Klan using eugenics to justify their racist goals.
Ma il razzismo psichiatrico non era esclusivamente americano. Alcuni dei peggiori abusi del XX secolo ebbero luogo in Sudafrica, dove il governo adottò le stesse teorie e pratiche razziste usate da Hitler. Non era una coincidenza. Il primo ministro aveva studiato l'eugenetica come studente di psicologia negli anni 20 nella Germania nazista.
Dr. Heinrich Verwoerd is regarded as the architect of apartheid. He saw South Africa as a divided state with whites, blacks and brown people living in totally separate areas with black people having no rights whatsoever.
Mentre l'apartheid era in vigore, gli psichiatri istituirono ospedali psichiatrici in tutto il paese, che non erano in realtà niente più che campi di lavoro per schiavi.
These places operated under a private company by the name of Smith Mitchell and Company. They were saving money through the cheap accommodation for psychiatric patients while making massive fortune out of money that Parliament had appropriated for medication. So it was a corrupt system.
Quando questa operazione venne finalmente smascherata, si scoprì che erano morti 22.000 pazienti. Mentre allo stesso tempo i campi psichiatrici avevano intascato 90 milioni di dollari. L'Organizzazione Mondiale della Sanità ha pubblicato un rapporto che dichiarava che la psichiatria aveva sostenuto il razzismo e che i suoi campi erano connessi alla proprietà e al commercio di schiavi. Nel 1972, negli Stati Uniti, lo psichiatra Louis Jolly West continuò l'eredità razzista della psichiatria, concependo un esperimento segreto sulla terapia dell'avversione chiamato Centro della Violenza. Il suo piano, finanziato dal governo, inserire elettrodi nel cervello dei maschi afroamericani e ispanici in modo da sottoporli a shock qualora dovessero mostrare un qualsiasi comportamento violento e se questo non funzionava, venivano castrati chimicamente con farmaci. Quando la proposta razzista di West oltraggiò il pubblico, il piano venne rapidamente archiviato. Sebbene le spietate teorie razziste della psichiatria avessero subito un duro colpo, non vennero fermate. Nel 1994 lo psicologo Richard Ernstein fu il coautore del libro La curva a campana, nel quale sosteneva di provare che i neri erano geneticamente disabili e perciò inferiori ai bianchi.
The bell curve really argues a very old eugenics idea. It argues that people are born with different kinds of intellectual abilities, that these are inborn pretty much at birth. It goes back to the notion that somehow black people are genetically and biologically inferior to white people as a way to justify what was really its programs of social racism and social sexism. And you see that kind of thinking going on in public school testing and IQ testing and educational testing and tracking.
And this new tool fit into that old mold. It was a new tool that could prove the intellectual inferiority of African Americans.
The psychiatric profession has done great damage, certainly in the past, and far too many in the present too, to subvert democracy and perpetuate racial stereotypes, even more deep racism in society.
We have to battle against this continual misinformation, disinformation, pseudoscience. It can be repackaged in whatever form or format it is. But if it is based solely upon the color of one's skin and then is the merit of that human being, I just reject it.
Così, oggi, la fiamma dell'odio continua a bruciare, alimentata da bugie pseudoscientifiche. Questa è l'eredità della psichiatria, come giustificazione per il razzismo e pretesto per la repressione politica.